mixed with a little bit of communication as well.
Absolutely.
Definitely have to communicate. It's more than that piece of paper we signed, definitely, when we got married. It's a lot.
Me and Demetrius were just polar opposites. You know, we love each other, but we were just so opposite.
Completely.
And I guess the hardest part was just being able, I grew up completely different than he did, and bringing our values into raising our kids, and just understanding where he comes from, and him understanding where I come from, and us becoming on one accord about it. You know, what's best for our children, or just everyday life, finances, things like that. We just did so different. I think more so he had apprehension on his part. I didn't.
I agree. It was some apprehension. I had just got out of a relationship. I was still young. And I think it took me finding who I was and exactly what I wanted in a relationship, and just making sure that, you know, well, hey, you know, this is the one and it can work out because X, Y, and Z. Just having the faith in it and just taking a leap of faith. I've grown, I've matured a lot. I think one of the hardest things for me was kind of forcing, you know, my views of life on things, how you mentioned earlier, how we just had different values. And it's like, why is she not getting it? You know, I came from a home, a two-parent home, and this is how it's supposed to be. So respecting her values and understanding her background, it took a lot for me to get a hold of that. And I'll probably change that.
I would change always being on the defense. You know, he didn't understand me. And I was always defensive. Like he said, he came from a two-parent household, and I came from a single mom. So everything was as if he was judging me. You know what I mean? I always, you think this is better. You think since you grew up in a two-parent household, it's better. So I always was on the defense. And I have to learn that he's my partner. You know, he's not my competitor, I guess.
Of course, I mean, just those core values that was, you know, instilled besides just going to church, but, you know, how I'm supposed to treat my wife, you know, how she's supposed to treat me when it came to decisions, you know, kind of agreeing and really aligning a lot of our themes with the Word of God. And because she didn't grow up in church, it was almost like I was trying to teach it to her or trying to explain it to her. Not saying that I was totally forcing it on her, but it proved to be challenging. She was willing, though. She was willing to learn.
Yeah, right. Back then, I thought he was forcing it on me. You know, because I didn't grow up in church. And I mean, I grew up in a family where we went to church on the holidays. It was Christmas, we went to church. It was Easter, we went to church, you know, and it was with the grandmother. It wasn't like my mom didn't take us to church. So I guess I did kind of feel like he was forcing it on me, and I had to like take a, it. And when he figured it out, and I took a step back to realize, okay, let me do this for me. Because if I'm doing it for you, it's not real. I really need to figure it out for me. But I have a husband that is like crazy ambitious. And if anytime I feel like pushing back, he's always pushing me forward. So I think that the most important thing that I've learned from me is just to set a goal and don't be afraid to set it high and don't be afraid to chase it. Because me, I'm really removed and I'm always like, I want to do this. And you know, always, maybe I can. And he's always, oh, you can. We are type of, and that's the biggest thing.
This woman, she keeps me aligned. I mean, with the different things that I struggle with, she's the type of person that, hey, honey, you know, bring it back in. I don't think you should do that. And which I struggled with in the beginning, like, trying to tell me what to do? You know, I'm grown. But, you know, stepping back and realizing, you know, she has my best interest. And just allowing her to play the role, you know, as a wife, as my best friend, as someone I can trust. And it really has been beneficial because before her, I was out there, you know, things that I struggled with. You know, not having anyone to talk to. But she gives me that confidence. You know, she's that rock. You know, she's solid. But, of course, we have goals, you know, financially, you know, even with our kids or some things that we want to do in terms of our career. But, you know, just really allowing God to direct us, and we won't become complacent or stagnant, and our love will be stronger.
And I hope in 5 years that we're still having fun. You know, I hope that we still have date nights, and I hope that we still have her put the kids to bed and, you know, just have some time for us nights, you know? Shut up. No, because you can't, because we have a 6-month-old, and when she, if she's not in bed, it's just like she's between me and him, you know? We need to, we gotta have some, I hope that we still are at the point where we feel like we do need time to connect, because sometimes we get so wrapped up in our kids. Me, personally, I get super wrapped up in my kids that when we vacation without them, I miss them. And I just hope that when we get 5 years from now, that we're still in that, that we need to make sure that husband and wife are